Michael O'Brien is confident he'll retain the Liberal leadership despite preparing to face a party room spill tomorrow morning. Mark Santomartino has the latest. Mark, he's just spoken to us. What's he had to say?
Well, he was putting on a brave face, Pete, given that one of his shadow ministers, Brad Batten, is counting the numbers against him tonight. We understand that come tomorrow morning, the former police officer and bakery owner will launch a challenge against Michael O'Brien's leadership. He's held the top job since 2018, when under Matthew Guy, the Liberal Party was thumped by Daniel Andrews. And Michael O'Brien says he is still the best man for the job.
I'm confident that my party leadership will be endorsed and supported by the party. As a former treasurer, we know that rebuilding this state and the economics rebuild of this state is so critical, and who better place than a former treasurer to do what we need to do.
Peter, comes after the Liberal Party was all but obliterated in the WA state election this week. But truth be told, Michael O'Brien has been hosing down speculation about his job for months. Last year, at the height of the COVID pandemic, his approval rating was just 15%, according to a Nine News Ipsos poll. Regardless, senior Liberals are backing him in.
Now is not the time for a leadership spill.
The spill motion, if it goes ahead, will not get up.
Whether Brad Batten changes the Liberal Party's fortunes is a big what if. All that drama will play out here at Parliament tomorrow, Pete. However, Daniel Andrews will be watching from home after he was discharged from hospital this morning.
Mark.
A portrait of Daniel Andrews wishing he'd get well soon. Parting gifts from kids in Alfred Hospital's childcare as the Premier heads home. "It's been a long, painful and difficult week," said Mr. Andrews. "I narrowly avoided permanent damage to my spinal cord. That's why I will take a leave of absence from my duties for at least 6 weeks.
We'll hold the fort in Parliament this week whilst he continues his important focus on his recovery.
Daniel Andrews suffered an acute compression fracture of his T7 vertebra in a fall down wet wooden steps. That's also cracked at least 5 of his ribs. These are serious injuries that require me to wear a brace throughout each day, except when sleeping. I'm not sure about buying a Tats Lotto ticket, but I'm certain that with rest, continued high quality care and the support of family, friends, colleagues and the Victorian community, I'll be back doing the job I love as soon as possible."
Daniel does love his job. I'm sure there is parts of him that are keeping an eye on us, but it's also too, he's sensible.
Jacinta Allen hasn't called the Premier, but
might have even sent him a couple of pictures of some of the work sites I've been on as well.
Today, that site was Anzac Station, and the reveal of what it will look like from the shrine, with boring machines on their final leg of the Metro Tunnel dig.
You could be 2 minutes into the heart of the CBD, 10 minutes out to Parkville.
St Kilda Road will look a little different when the tunnel's finished in 2025. Animations showing off double bike lanes between Dorcas Street and Toorak Road. Originally, there was space for 3 car lanes either side of St Kilda Road, but to keep on-street parking, that's been cut to 2.
The impact of even going to one lane is only something like a minute and a half heading into the city and half a minute coming out.
Mark Santomartino, Nine News.